Now I am going to explain the behavior of lens in the liquid. Then what is the behavior of lens? For the purpose, what we have to do it here, look at here. And I am taking a lens. Initially, this lens is in the air medium. Okay. In the air medium, the lens refractive index we can take as FA. FA is the focal length of lens. In air medium. Okay. Now what I did, I dipped the lens in the liquid. Then the focal length we can consider as FL. FL is the focal length of lens in liquid medium. Okay. Then how the focal length will be changes, and that we have to know. Then some more terms I will give. For example, this is the new lens or the new glass. It is the refractive index of lens, refractive index of material of lens. Lens is made with some material. If it is made with glass, it is the glass. Refractive index of material of lens and refractive index of air is generally we will take as 1, and the refractive index of liquid we can take as new liquid. Okay, this we can take as refractive index of liquid. And now in the air, how to write the formula? Okay, focal length, to find the focal length of lens in air. Focal length of lens in air medium I want. In air medium. That is 1 by F suffix A. Okay. It is equal to. Now we write here refractive index of lens. It is in air medium. That's why we have to write air with respect to air. Minus 1 into. We write as 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. We know lens maker formula. 1 by F equal nu minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. That formula we have to use it here. And the focal length of lens in the liquid I want. Focal length of lens in liquid medium. What happens? If we dip the lens in the liquid medium, what happens? That is 1 by F liquid we write here. This we will get as refractive index of lens, the same lens we have to write. But with respect to liquid, we have to take. The medium is changed. The medium is liquid. That's why we have to write like this. And that is, oh, this is the liquid minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2 we have to write. This is equation 2. And now you divide the two equations. Equation 1 by equation 2 if we will do. Then when you will divide like this, 1 by FA by 1 by FL. On the right side, that is the air medium refractive index of lens minus 1 by liquid refractive index of lens minus 1. The remaining will be cancelled. Then this will be like this there, that is FL by FA. FL by FA we will get here. FL by FA we will get as, this is new lens by new A. New air, but the new air is 1 minus 1 by FL by FA. We write like this. This you write as new lens by new air. New refractiveness of lens with respect to air. 1 new 2 we write as new 2 by new 1. Here air new lens we write as new lens by new air. But the new air value is 1. So we will get only new lens by refractive index of lens by refractive index of liquid minus 1 we will get. This is the formula we are getting to find the focal length of lens in the liquid. If you want to write the focal length in the liquid, then we write like this. That is new lens minus 1 by new lens by new liquid minus 1 into FA we have to write. What I did it here, just I am taking FA to right side, then you will get like this. Okay, and now let us see here some more points I am going to explain. You take the screenshot and note it. Okay, look at here. We got a final equation for the focal length of the lens in the liquid. This is the equation that we got. And by using above equation, we will get 3, we will get 3 cases. Let us see the case 1. What is case 1? Case 1 is that if refractive index of lens, material of lens is more than the refractive index of liquid, then what happens? That if FA is positive, FL also positive, or from this we can write this equation like this also. FL is equal to new lens minus 1 by new lens minus new liquid by new liquid into FA we are getting here. Okay, this is the same equation. Look this. What we are doing it here, what we are getting it here, just we are doing the LCM it here in this equation, in the left side equation, we will get this equation. Okay, otherwise, we write here once again neatly. For example, from above equations, if we are doing that in the denominator LCM, new lens minus new liquid by new liquid, you will get this. New liquid maybe goes to numerator, right? If you go for the If you take the consideration that is refractive index of lens is greater than the refractive index of liquid, then what happens if this multiplier will become positive? New lens is always positive, always greater than 1, and the new lens minus new liquid will become greater and positive. This new lens greater than new liquid means this will become greater positive. From above equation you see new lens minus new liquid is there. New lens greater than new liquid is there, then new lens minus new liquid you will get positive. Then when new lens minus new liquid is positive, then FL and FA have the same sign. FL and FA have same sign. That means if FA is positive, then FL is also positive. If FA is negative, FL is negative. Okay? Right. That means nature of lens does not changes. Nature of lens does not changes. That means convex lens behaves, convex lens in air, convex lens behaves like convex, and concave lens behaves like concave after dipping in the liquid. Okay, its nature does not changes. When its nature does not changes, how the diagram will be there? For example, this is the refractive index of the lens. This is the convex lens. It is kept in the liquid, and this is the liquid. And I'm taking the tool address at here and are incidenting it here parallelly. And then they will be converge at a point and they will meet at a point. And this is the principal focus. And now the convex lens behaves like convex lens. The refractive index of the liquid is, the refractive index of liquid is new liquid. And we write all the diagrams at one place. It is better for easy understanding. Nature does not change. Let us go for the case 2. The case 2 is that if refractive index of lens is less than the refractive index of liquid, then FL and FA have opposite signs. Why they have the opposite signs? You see the equation. If FA positive you take, and new lens less new liquid you take. New lens minus new liquid you will get negative, because new lens less than new liquid, less minus more negative. FA is positive, then this negative into positive will give positive. Sorry, negative, and FL will be negative. New lens minus new liquid, this bracket term, it is positive. For example, new lens less than new liquid means that will be negative. What you will get here? You will get like this equation. FL is equal to negative of FA we will get. That means if FA is positive, then bracket term will become negative because new lens less than new liquid. Then if FA is positive, FA is positive, then FL will become negative. And if FA is negative, then what happens? FL will become positive. That means nature of lens changes. Convex lens in the liquid, convex lens behaves like a concave lens because positive become negative. Focal length of the lens in air is positive and the focal length of the lens in the liquid is negative. Convex lens behaves like focal length of the air is positive. Focal length of the air is positive, then focal length of the liquid is negative. If the focal length of the air is negative, then focal length of the liquid is positive. Here, focal length of the lens is negative of focal length of the air. You substitute here FEI is positive, then you will get FLI is negative. If you substitute FEI is negative, then FLI you will get is negative into negative, positive you will get. That means opposite sign. Focal length of the lens in the air is positive, right? We can take it as convex. When it is dip in the liquid, it will be, it has negative focal length, but the negative focal length is for the concave, right? Convex has positive focal length. Convex has, for the convex lens, focal length is positive. For concave lens, you remember, the focal length is negative, right? You have to take this is always, it is always true, okay? Right. Then convex lens behaves like concave. And concave lens behaves like convex. Behaves like convex when we dip them in liquid. This is about case 2. Now let us discuss about the case 3. The case 3 is that I am going to rub all the things and you take the screenshot and note it. Okay. The next third case is that if the refractive index of lens is equal to refractive index of liquid, then if you find out the focal length of the lens in the liquid, if you dip the lens in the liquid whose refractive index is equal to the refractive index of the lens, then the focal length of the lens in the liquid becomes infinite. Okay, and we have the formula, right? FL is equal to focal length of the lens in the liquid is equal to nu lens minus 1 by nu lens by nu liquid minus 1 into FA. From this, if you substitute the nu lens is equal to nu liquid, these two will be cancelled. 1 minus 1 we will get in the denominator, that is 0. Something by 0 you will get is infinite. Focal length is infinite means then lens in the liquid behaves like a plain glass plate. Lens in liquid behaves like a plain glass plate and it does not appear in the liquid and it does not appear in liquid. If let us go for the some diagram. If it is not appear in the liquid, then how it will appear? Okay. Let us see, let us draw some pictures related to this. For example, this is a liquid. This is a lens, convex, and this is concave. What happening it here? This convex behaves like convex only. No. This convex behaves as if the refractive index of lens. This is the lens. Refractive index is equal to refractive index of the liquid. It will behave like plain glass plate. That means if you take the light rays, in light ray will go in straight without any bending. Why? Because there is no change in the refractive index, no change in the medium. Light ray will go in the straight without any deviation. This is the case when the refractive index of lens is equal to refractive index of liquid. And now let us discuss some more case. In this, what happening it here in this case, in case 3, convex or concave, right? Convex and concave lens behaves like a plain glass plate, no refraction. And some note, two diagrams I will draw it here in the note. That is, for example, I am taking refractive index of the lens is greater than refractive index of the liquid. For example, this is the lens, convex lens, and this is the refractive index. Refractive index is new lens, that is greater than the new liquid, then its nature does not changes. Nature does not changes means convex behaves like convex. You know the nature of the convex, right? All the light rays will meet at a point on the principal axis and image forms on the principal axis. And now another diagram we will take. Concave lens we will take. If you take the concave lens, that this is the concave lens, right? This is the diverging lens. I am taking the case that the refractive index of the lens is greater than refractive index of the liquid. Then no change in the behavior. That means concave is a diverging lens. This is converging. And this is the diverging. It is concave lens. Now, if we draw the diagrams, then we will get like this. It will be diverged. Its behavior does not changes. Again, it like just like convex only. And the next case I am taking that if the lens is in this is A and B diagrams. Now I am taking the case that this is convex lens, but when we dip this convex lens in a liquid, that is the refractive index of lens is less than the refractive index of liquid, but actually it is a convex lens, but when refractive index of lens less than refractive index of liquid, at that moment its behavior changes in the cases we discussed. It will act like diverging lens. That it will diverge the light rays and image forms it here. And next, I am taking the concave lens it here. दिस इज प्रिंसिपल एक्ट एंड आई एम टेकिंग द केस दैट द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ द लेंस इज लेस देन द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ लिक्विड. देन व्हाट हैपेंस? कॉन्वेक्स बिहेव्स लाइक अ कॉनकेव. Concave behaves like a convex. That means if the light rays parallelly incidents, after the refraction, they will meet at a point. What happening at here? Here in these two cases, this is the C and this is the D. In this, convex changes as concave and concave changes as okay, these are the some diagrams, important diagrams. Let us discuss one problem here based on this concept. A glass convex lens of refractive index. The lens refractive index is, lens is made with the glass whose refractive index is 3 by 2. That is 1.5 nearly. And it is a how the focal length has got focal length equal to 0.3 meters. This is in the air, right? Focal length has got focal length equal to 0.3 meters. That is the focal length in air they give, right? That is 0.3 meters. 0.3 meters. Generally, the focal length is with respect to vacuum or air will be there. That is 0.3 meters. Now it is dip in the water. Okay, the liquid is the water. The water refractive index is they give us 4 by 3. Then what happens? It's to its focal length. We have to find out the focal length of the lens in the liquid and we have to tell the nature also. Right? Initially, that is a convex lens. That's why the focal length is positive at here. Focal length is 0.3 meters in the air medium. That is plus 0.3 meters because it is convex lens. We have the formula here, focal length of the lens in the liquid by focal length in the air is equal to refractive index of lens minus 1 by refractive index of lens by refractive index of liquid minus 1. This is the formula. In this we substitute all values. FL we don't know. Right, FA we know 0.3, it is equal to new lens minus 1, that is 3 by 2 minus 1 by new lens by new liquid, that is 3 by 2 by new liquid is 4 by 3 minus 1. Now we have to simplify this. When you will simplify, FL by 0.3 is equal to, we will get as 3 by 2 minus 1 by 3 minus 2 by 2. 1 by 2 we will get in the numerator. In the denominator we will get as 9 by 8. That means 9 minus 8 by 8. 1 by 8 we will get. This will become 8 by 1. And 2 4 we will get. We will get as FL is equal finally 0.3 into 4 plus 1.2. centimeters you will get. That means focal length in the lens in the liquid also we got positive. That means a convex lens in the liquid behaves like a convex lens. No change in the nature. Also we know that refractive index of lens is greater than the refractive index of the liquid. That's why also directly without solving the problem also we can tell the convex lens behaves like convex lens. There is no change in the nature, right?